Clad in the church attire, the pastor of Makere Community Church, Dr. Martin Semper, has today appeared before the Equal Opportunities Commission Court in company with his lawyer, Gawaya Tegule, to answer queries of the alleged stigmatization of people living with HIV.
I wanted to find out if you know what the white class pageant is all about.
I think it would be good for you to pull out the record. Because my words were clear. I never said white class. If you're going to ask me about my words, I'll answer about my words.
Okay.
This is my words. And I would ask you if you maybe show me where I've said white class.
No, it is hard to ask you.
Yeah.
I'm asking.
So here, this is my words. I said, here is the problem with this whole issue. A beauty contest of the prettiest girl with HIV is a campaign to sexualize and make normal having a deadly and contagious virus.
The legal team of the Center for Health, Human Rights and Development, CEHAD, a body which dragged Semper before this commission, started with cross-examining him. Among the questions was whether he knew the definition of stigmatization, why he used his Twitter handle to talk ill about Miss HIV beauty pageant, among others.
HIV/AIDS is a confidential fact, and in fact it's criminal to reveal someone's HIV status or assume someone's HIV status. So I have never talked to Gloria. I don't know if she's HIV positive. She's never given me her HIV/AIDS certificate.
In his submission, Pastor Semper, together with his lawyer, denied the accusations, explaining that his Twitter posts were misinterpreted.
Your opinion was that the beauty pageant, the way it was organized and publicized, had a high risk of escalating the HIV infection rather than deflating stigma of any sort.
Yes, having worked with young people for more than 30 years, and the fact that young people are the majority of the new HIV infections, as I say.
Semper further wondered why, of all people on Twitter who commented on the Y positive beauty pageant, they only accused him of stigmatization.
I'm a farmer.
Okay.
I'm a pastor.
Mm-hmm.
I've just got a consultancy with MTN to teach on Bafere.
Mm-hmm.
So I do cyber criminal fraud. I'm a public education specialist. I'm working on drug, discouraging people from getting drugs. I cancel marriages.
Dorothy Amoron, the advocate for Center for Health, Human Rights and Development, called for a tough penalty for Pastor Semper.
It's like beauty pageants, like just like any other person that is not having the virus.
After listening to the submissions from both parties, the vice chairperson of the Equal Opportunities Commission, Joel Cox Ajuko, decided to adjourn the case hearing to the 19th of this month. Relatedly, health rights activists have called for reforms in the current laws on HIV/AIDS, which, according to them, are criminalizing persons living with HIV/AIDS in the country.
So that means that if I'm in my house, I'm HIV positive, and my family around me, they are at risk. Of course, that is not right. I think the way I've gone with science is that HIV is not transmitted through continuous contact, unless it is maybe if we share sharp instruments.
Section 41 and 43 of the HIV/AIDS Prevention and Control Act of 2014 criminalizes attempted and intentional transmission of HIV. However, according to the activists, this is intended to stigmatize people with HIV and may force many of them to hide their HIV statuses.
If a government educates its people well, if a government does 1, 2, 3 in empowering and accompanying people, then the results will be long life, health, well-being. But now we have left that. We are just focusing on the individual. Yet the individual also depends on government.
These have recommended a number of reforms to the current laws on HIV/AIDS to ensure equity. Justice Victoria Katamba, on behalf of the judiciary, says they are doing their best to ensure that there is equal dispensation of justice to every Ugandan, regardless of their HIV/AIDS status.
So when they come, we do not first establish what their status is. Even in a criminal session where we know, for example, from Police Form 24, that somebody had HIV that may be used as a mitigating factor instead of an aggravating factor, depending on the circumstances, because each case is determined on its own merits.
Rachel Nachuala and Jeliet Namuwaya for the news.